Hi, I'm Ann from the Chocolate Bells, and today I'm going to show you how to do the pretzel pops. I have a couple of Easter ones here. This one happens to be a little bunny. He's holding a cute little carrot. And this one over here is a carrot mold. I love this mold. It's so cute. We're going to be doing this little bunny here in just chocolate, and it really works out very nicely. It's very simple. I have my chocolate melted here in the squeeze bottle. Just going to take that squeeze bottle filled with the melted chocolate and squeeze it into the mold. Just take and squeeze that right in there like that. And now you don't want to put too much chocolate in these. Underfilling is better than overfilling in the case of the pretzels. Just squeeze that right in there. Fill it up. These are done in no time at all. Now we give this a little tap, just like that, and I have the pretzel rods over here. I always buy them in the canister because there's less breakage on them. And you just take this pretzel and you place it down in there. I don't twist the pretzels. I just place these in the mold, making sure that they're secure in there. And place it down in like that, and like that. Sometimes those pretzels have a little curl to them, but you work with it. And then you just place that in the freezer, and in about 5 to 10 minutes, they'll be done. The nice part of the pretzel molds is you eat everything. There's no waste. All right, over here, I have some green chocolate melted in the squeeze bottle, and I have some orange chocolate melted. And this carrot, we're going to give it a little green top and a little orange bottom over here. And you're going to take your painting squeeze bottle and you take and you just squeeze that into the mold. And you use the tip like an applicator, like a paintbrush. And you place the green chocolate in there. Just go back and do all that coloring. This is so simple. The kids can help you with this. And the chocolate's never hot. It's only warm to the touch, so no one's going to get hurt. Children aren't going to be burned with the chocolate. You just take and paint that right in there. Now you could pour these in chocolate too, but I like orange carrots. I take my orange chocolate and I just squeeze it into the mold. Now usually I let that harden, but there's so little painting. I just squeeze it in there then, my orange. Now you don't want to put too much chocolate, but get it in the tops so that they're nice and secure. Just squeeze that in there. There you go. Squeeze some more in over here. Now this is just white chocolate tinted to orange. Tastes really yummy. All the kids like it. Those of you who like milk or dark chocolate, I'm sure you can do them in milk and dark chocolate too. Over here, we're going to give them a nice little tap. Then we take our pretzel rods again, place that right into the mold, just like that, and like that, and right down in there, and here goes the last one. And then you have your assistant, John, put them in the freezer. Don't you all wish you had John to put them in the freezer for you? And he's going to take out... John, I have some lambs in the freezer. Would you take those out, please?
Sure.
Are they done yet?
They look like they need a little more. Well, they're done. Come on.
Okay. Excuse me. I'm going to take these and give them a little push on the bottom. Oops. Maybe they're not quite done yet. Well, let's turn it over. John got this one out. I know that. Oh, see, this is what happens if it's not done enough. Has to go back in the freezer a little bit longer. John, you want to put that back in for me? And we'll get back with those finished pieces in 1 second. Hi. Here we are with our lamb pretzel pop that I have here. Now it's freshly out of the mold. And all you're going to do, what I like to do with this one here, is I take... Now I need a little lollipop stick here because this is a little bit big hole in my, I have a large hole in my squeeze bottle. So what I'm going to do is take, I have some eyeballs here, And take these little eyeballs and a little dab of melted chocolate right over here. And we're going to take and pick up that little eyeball and stick it right on. And then over here, another little dab of melted chocolate. And put that one right on. Now there you go, isn't that cute? Very nice lollipop, pretzel pop. You can stick that right in your children's basket. Okay, now John is bringing me the carrots that I had made previously. And over here, we're going to gently lift on the stick. And there we go, we have our carrot pops already done. Aren't they beautiful? Make a little carrot patch right in your Easter basket. Just picture all the kids munching on these Easter Sunday. And John, I also have that small bunny in there. I made another little rabbit. And he is really, really cute. These are just adorable. Oh, John says our little bunnies aren't done yet, so we'll put those back in. But basically, you have the general idea on how to make your pretzel pops. I'm sure that you can do these with the children at home and they'll have a wonderful time. Or you just want to surprise them Easter Sunday morning with their basket full of carrots and lambs and bunnies. And they should enjoy every little bit of it right down to the end of the stick. Well, you all have a happy Easter and enjoy your candy making.